My name is Sheba Najmi, and I'm the founder and executive director of Code for Pakistan, which is a nonprofit organization that's trying to create innovation in public services in Pakistan. I'm also a senior user experience strategist at a digital agency in San Francisco called Exigy, which focuses on working with social impact clients, particularly in the civic technology space. In Pakistan, civic technology as a term is very new. We were the ones who introduced it about 3 years ago. But now it's pretty exciting to see that there are a couple of other organizations that are using the term civic innovation, and more is happening in that space. It's all centered, for me, it's all centered around the main issue being a two-sided issue, which is one, a lack of civic engagement. That's primarily because in a country like Pakistan, people have generally given up on government. They see it as corrupt and bureaucratic and inefficient. And so there's not a lot of hope for their voices mattering or for them being able to make an impact. And on the other side of it, government isn't very citizen-focused either, because they think that all citizens do is complain. So this is really about bringing both sides to the table. Impact in the sense of civic technology specifically means being able to make people's lives better, and doing that through leveraging things like technology to create solutions in new ways that can actually help in people's daily lives, in particular in the public sector where they intersect with government. Measuring impact in governance is something that takes it's something we're still learning about. It's not something that I expect to see a huge transformation in my lifetime. I'm not holding my breath. But at the same time, it's something that I'm fully conscious that, you know, nothing that's worth doing is easy, to quote or misquote Theodore Roosevelt. And so we're in it for the long haul. With civic technology, what's interesting is that there's a whole spectrum. There are things from opening up data and visualizing that information, which is something that can be very impactful for journalists or NGOs that are using that, consuming that data. There are things around citizen reporting applications, which really depend on somebody from government taking note and using those, so those often don't go as well. I hope that civic technology will lead to a kind of shared ownership and shared responsibility between people and government. So people taking more ownership of their cities and of their of being a part of their local government. That would be the ideal. I think also what's really key is that civic technology serve those who have much less of a voice than those of us in this room do, and have a much greater need than most of us do, because those are often the people that are most ignored by government and have the greatest needs. With TikTok, I really wanted to see what else is going on in the world. I wanted to learn about how people are measuring impact, in particular because that's such a new space for civic technology, and also how we can collaborate on projects across geographies. It's been great to talk to some folks. I've actually had some people with Pakistani backgrounds seek me out and say, hey, we want to be a part of this civic tech movement that you started in Pakistan, which is very exciting, you know, to grow the organization and have people join us. It's also great to talk to others from Africa and Germany about projects that they're working on to do with measuring air quality using sensors, and think about how we can use that in our context, because these are open source projects and you can share and collaborate, how we can adapt that to maybe measuring traffic congestion, because that's a project we're working on, and where there are opportunities for collaboration. So those sorts of conversations have been great. The talks have all been really wonderful, learned a ton. So yeah, thank you for having me at TikTok.